Hello, and welcome back to Sailor Moon RPG Part 44. And you know what? It's our last episode of this game. That's right, we're gonna go end this today. It has been a long time waiting for this. But first, we have to deal with the final boss. So I'll hold my final thoughts till after we're done playing today. To begin, we're going to search around the Crystal Palace a bit more. For really nothing, because I never find anything when searching anything in this game. Sailor Mercury's area? Venus? I didn't get a good look at the icon in the door. Not that it matters, you never find anything specific in these areas. Yeah, these curtains hide nothing. So, for those of you who missed the ending of the last episode, we're supposed to go down into the basement to fight the final boss. I'm just dragging my feet around searching the palace. To be fair, I'm looking for two more puzzle pieces, hoping the game left some behind. Apparently, if you collect all the puzzle pieces, they'll give you another item. I don't remember what it is. And I never actually went to look it up again, but it might just be another red pupil. Anyway, we're gonna head down to face off with Apsu's second form. This time she combined with Sin to make an even stronger form. Stronger, we'll see about that. Alright, here we go. That was the room with that stand in there I went in earlier. And nothing else. Yeah, but it's the Earth of the future! Our Earth will be fine! No, Chibi Moon, I just don't want to deal with you. Stay behind. Who will defend future me and future husband of mine? What? That's what it comes down to. So here we go. Who will fight and who will defend? And I will tell you in a little while why this notion is so ridiculous. So I'm going to pick the most overpowered fighters we have to go with Sailor Moon. Final battle, right? Let's go! Alright, it's a final battle, and we're gonna crush her. No mercy. Yes, also make sure your positioning is correct before going in. Huh, strange, no music on this segment. That looks about right. So here's where the Tower of Time should be, which is weird because that's not what was behind the door there. Nope! It's a woman riding a dragon head! What's with that body? It's so awesome! And again, the villain decides to do this stupid thing. although she does have a reason behind it. She destroys the castle. Finding the crystal would be a bit tricky. And again, she turns away from her to say that line. Face the camera when you say it. Don't forget it. And Demon Epsu looks so much better in the sprite form. Hell, she takes up most of the screen. I definitely love this final boss. Oh god, she doesn't do much damage. She doesn't take much damage, sorry. Ah! That was my best character! Now she barely does scratch damage. Well, I hate to say it, but I might have lied earlier. We might be in for another episode of Sailor Moon RPG. Let's give him some power up that might help us out with this. She has a useless attack still. Those two are hitting better. That's still doing barely anything! Giant floating dragon head with a woman riding it. It's gonna be hard to top this final boss. What was this? What is this? Ah, negative attack! That kills me. Mustn't give up, must press on. What does that do? Oh, yeah, that's this attack. No, it's this attack! Ah! I will not let her win. Okay, Come on, Sailor Mars! Hadouken! 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 That might be game over. Okay. I clearly do not care. Oh, now the village is just screwing around with me. Well, at least we get another shot. When was the last time I saved? Wait, what is this? Well, to be fair, she does turn into the Queen of the Galaxy, I believe, at the end of the, fifth season, so yeah. Oh no, this is gonna be a brutal bloodbath. Those are the four people I didn't want in this battle. It's we'd be the present moon, we're in the future! Ah! So, this is wonderful setup. Clearly not the best way I would have had this ordered, but I didn't get to choose my formation this time. Maybe I'll get lucky. Damn! Damn! I don't need to say it anymore. What the hell happened here? Okay. So now she has no defense, and no attack. What? What? What happened? Why is she so simple now? It's not like we hit her with the silver crystal, or anything. It's just, now, Chibi Moon's fighting, and they're doing well. You know what, this game's almost over, why am I complaining? And now I get to use a lot of linked attacks I didn't get to try out earlier. Cause why not? We're not losing this. Ooh, deep scream sounds nice. Eh, what isn't too interesting? Double water for the win! Water plus thunder equals ow! Okay, electricity, but... cool, I guess, even though it didn't do too much damage. Regular attacks do like 1,000 damage to her. Oh crud, here comes this one. This is gonna be an instant kill. What? This is insanely ridiculous. She still looks cool though. Well, this is making it into my final review of this game. We might as well start using... wait, what am I using? I really think you have to try to fail this battle. Which might give me something to do afterwards. I wonder how deadly Time Stop is with her. Well, we're about to find out now, aren't we? Here we go! Ah! It's like they multiplied any attack by like 100. And then took that 100 they multiplied the attack with and divided her attacks with wasnt. Thank you. little bit hard. Get it? Because the two planets are so far away. Here we go. Meh. Pretty good final boss music, though. Then again, as long as they don't loop it for like 3 hours, I can probably stand anything. Still has a useless attack. Why am I making her defend? Her attacks don't do enough damage to warrant defense. Our final fragrance. Perfect timing. To be fair, probably could have used it earlier. Would have sped up the battle a bit. Maybe it would have given me a one-hit kill. Going too fast. Yeah, I don't think I need to say this battle ain't gonna take much longer. I'm pretty sure you all can see that. Who's gonna get the kill? Oh, Mercury. And the dragon head remains behind. That's kind of weird. Well, you find that she didn't really dissolve into nothing, though. I say Mama and Papa twice. Just blast the little twerp. Could have done it, and won. You're not the villain I thought you were, Epsu. Pretty nice music, too, in this cutscene. Maybe mixing your body with the sister or the guy you're trying to kill, not the smartest move, but again, you had no way of knowing this would happen. Double moon prism power, and the big bad is toast. The fates are starting to change back to normal. It takes so much to tell her that he's not really dying. It's so weird. Actually, this gets kind of heartbreaking fast, so... Thank God we have a resident Time Lord. That's not true either, for that sense, but she does know a bit about time. Yeah, I don't kind of get this part. So they're pretty much saying that if Chibi Moon and Ants star meet again, they could reverse what they all just did. And the Zito sense scouts, and everything would just start over. Which makes little to no sense, really, but... oh well. Far be it for me to ask for sense in this show. And she totally forgets that warning and decides to talk to him anyway. So apparently by returning them to their original fates, they didn't really erase anything that happened during the, battle, because I think she gave him that locket. And it's Trista. Or... and with that, I think we're done. Eerie clock chimes. Haunting ending. Oh! The main theme.
Fighting evil by moonlight, winning love by daylight. Never win from a real fight. She is the one called Sailor Moon.
Okay, I really can't follow this instrumentation with it. Moose M. You gotta love some of the names they throw at the on these ending credits. Cecile Stormclaw. As a webmaster, wait. Ramon, oh, that's the people who physically translated the game. They did a pretty good job, actually. Minus a couple errors. I'll see you again right after this to give a small review of the game. What happens next? Does it go back to start, or does it just stay on this picture? Oh, it goes back to start. Cool. Let's do a fast review of Sailor Moon RPG so I can finish this tonight. For starters, this game was long, clocking in at about 16 hours of the final video time. It was probably a little bit longer, considering I had to speed up footage to get through a couple boss fights. I also had to get through a lot of grinding segments that would have added about 4 more hours onto this game. Yay! That's my own fault, though. I really can't blame this game for doing that, considering it is an RPG. That is what they do. Take a long time to complete. I really did like a lot of the bosses in this game. Definitely Demon Apsu at the end there with her style. Although, was there any way I could have failed that fight? Really? After playing for 20 some odd hours, I'll take the free win. This game actually did get tricky at some points. The Negamoon Sisters area was a pain. The opposite scouts at the very end was a pain. The dragon. If you go for that dragon, that is a hard boss fight in the end. Definitely a longer one. They took up 2 episodes of my time. Pretty nice, though. I like the characters they threw in there. Pretty much just everybody from the show, they could find a way to fit into this game, they did. For better or worse. I mean, I'm pretty sure that's why it took 20 hours to complete, is because I had to go through the Nega Moon arc, the Heart Snatcher arc, and the Barrel arc. Barrel! More with this. It's kind of disappointing that it didn't let me fight Fiora. Or Fury. The plant guy that Tuxedo Mask fought with. Off screen. Oh well. But that's only one boss out of every other boss they had in the show. The continuity problems I was having tend to be more I wasn't really fully paying attention to the story. Until I was. And then I was lost. But that makes sense. For the Sailor Scouts... Did I go over Sailor Scouts? No, I didn't. Sorry. For Sailor Scouts, person I called useless that really probably wasn't useless was Jupiter. I didn't have the right items. I've already mentioned this for her. For Sailor Scouts you really, really want on your team, I find that you really want Pluto. Stopping time is really helpful. You kind of really want Uranus. Uranus does a lot of damage. You kind of really want Venus is helpful. You definitely, if you don't take any of those 3 advices, you definitely want Saturn, and it definitely showed why in that whole thing. So, what's the next game on my agenda? I mean, I'm not just going to be playing Sailor Moon for the entire show. I hope. Well, I'm not actually going to disclose that right now. Yeah, I'm actually going to learn from Vitrice's mistakes and use my introduction video to introduce what my next episode will be. I will see you guys then. Although, little last note, it won't be an RPG game. See you then. Bye.